Hey folks, thanks for joining me again today. So, the previous two videos have kind of blown up a little bit. I wasn't exactly expecting that, but there we go. There's been a lot of mixed comments. Some people thought that the Neve and the Behringer sounded really different from each other. Other people thought they sounded quite similar. So, there were a few requests in there to do null tests, so that's what we're going to do today. It's going to be a quick video. I'm going to run the null tests so you can hear for yourself exactly what the difference is between them, scientifically speaking, right? And then that, in theory, should put the arguments to bed. So let's get on with it. I'll jump into Pro Tools and show you what we've got going. Alright, so here's how I've got this set up. I've got a sample of the song that I was previously showing in the video to keep the, you know, frame of reference the same. I've also got us some pink noise and also some white noise. Now, how I've got this set up is the three tracks feed into this bus here. And this bus here has the Behringer first of all, and then a trim plugin. Now the reason it's got a trim plugin, and I'll show you the difference, it's adding 0.4 dB. And the reason was, I matched the gain as closely as I possibly could for gain reduction, based on the music source, threshold, everything else. In fact, let me show you. As you can see, the limiter section is off, and the recovery is set to 100, threshold, gain, and the ratio is 2:1, comp is in, it's on fast attack, and it is on mono. For the Neve, threshold's the same, recovery 100, gain is about the same, ratio is 2:1, comp is in, and it's set to multi-mono. So they are set about the same, give or take. Focus. So we would say they're set about the same, right? Here's the thing. The Neve has an ever so slightly higher output than the Behringer, believe it or not. And because the stepped, I couldn't quite get them to be perfect. So the only way I could get them to be perfect was by going into the Behringer first, so it's being hit with the consistent signal, and then juicing the output in Pro Tools before it bounces to this Behringer track by 0.4 dB, which gives me a consistent minus 11.8 or whatever it is. And then I disable both of these plugins and run the same tests through the Neve, which also comes out at minus 11.8. So now we've got the signals through the compressors, similar settings, done, identical. Here they are together, without the phase being flipped. We'll go white noise first, why not? So this plugin here is bypassed and all it is, no gain adjustment, it's just a phase flip. So together, fingers and ears, it's just white noise, right? We flip the phase, again, interesting. Let's go to pink noise. Pink noise, both together we have. Delightful. With the phase flipped, again, and again. Finally, let's have a listen to the music piece, both together. Phase flipped. And again. And again. Alright, so what I'm perceiving as a difference in the white noise and pink noise, I'll be honest, all I'm really hearing is pretty much hiss. Very, very, very high end. I'm not hearing a massive amount of difference there. On the source material, on the actual song, you can hear pulsating, sounds like a choppy radio. To me, that's probably indicative of the compression and the attack. I think perhaps one is grabbier than the other, and it's clamping down a bit quicker, which is giving you that pumping noise. But when they do meet, there's near enough silence, which is why it chops in and out. So if we go back to my previous video, are they identical? No, they're not, but they're damn close, and you've got to admit they are damn close. And for me, my outlook on that hasn't changed. For, you know, a £2,000 price difference, there's not that much of a difference. Let's be honest about it, there's not that much of a difference. And I think it's impressive that the Behringer's got that close. And this isn't to say the Neve is bad, don't get me wrong. The Neve sounds fantastic, sure. But the Behringer sounds pretty damn good, you've got to admit. So again, I'll reiterate what I said in the previous video. If you're just getting into outboard and you're looking for a 33609 style compressor, the Behringer's a pretty good option. You know, the compression character is broadly in the same ballpark, and generally speaking, the units, to my ears at least, sound pretty alike. There are subtle differences between them. I think the Behringer distorts in a slightly different way, it saturates slightly differently to the Neve, but you know, the null test is right there, they're pretty similar. Anyway, hopefully that puts that to bed. I have had a few people ask me about null testing. There you go, enjoy. As always, feel free to comment below with your thoughts. I'm interested to hear them. I try to respond to everybody, but the influx of comments recently has been wild, and I'm struggling to get back to everybody, so apologies if I've missed you, but, you know, thank you, everybody, for watching. Thanks for your comments, good, bad, negative, whatever. Thank you. You know, there were some really good pieces of feedback in the last video, which I'm going to take forwards into future videos. There you go. Anyway, hope you have a nice evening, and be well until next time we meet.